Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
Not at all.
Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. We may have to stop when we can all have fun.
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Now, you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, Never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
See, it's cold.
I really can't stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
That you dropped in.
So very nice.
I'll hold your hand. They're just like
my
ice.
My mother will start to worry.
Beautiful, what's your
my
hurry?
My father will be peaceful.
Listen to the fireplace
now
roar.
Now really, I've got to scurry.
Beautiful, please don't.
Well, maybe just a half a drink
put
more.
Put some records on while I pour.
Neighbors might
hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says... Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
I ought to say no.
Mind if I move in closer?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out. Baby, it's cold outside.
Nice and comfortable.
I simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Look out the window at that store.
My sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the door.
Waves upon a tropical shore.
My maiden aunt's mind is vicious.
Your lips are delicious.
Well, maybe just a cigarette more.
Never such a pleasure before.
I gotta get
but
home.
But baby, you freeze out there.
Say, lend me
your knees out there.
Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's. Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retired,
Bay.
Please. How are you? Papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army would bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Grazie. Well, you can test it right now. Here. Take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock opens. Easy. Ah, damn it.
See you around, Giuseppe. Se benedì.
Easy, huh?
I'll see you
Don't
soon.
Don't worry,
Vito.
You'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car. Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Possible Grand Theft Auto.
Step on it.
Roger that. Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
Well, it's not over yet. Lose him. Quick.
10-4.
A buzzard took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Buzzy told the monkey, you are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free. The monkey monkey looking to buzz and ride dead in the eye. And said your story's so touching, sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Like we lost. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it.
After a meeting of the men who have come to be known as the Big Three in the European city of Yalta, not to be confused with his previous meeting on the Italian island of Malta. The president, along with Winston Churchill, persuaded Soviet leader Joseph Stalin that getting involved in the fight against the Japanese was in the best interest of all three nations. Before this meeting, the Soviets had only declared war on Germany. It's not known what President Roosevelt promised in return, but Stalin has pledged the full support of the Soviet armies in the war against Japan within 3 months of the surrender of Germany. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris.
Here, park right here in front of the garage door.
Time ago, a million years BC, the best things in life were absolutely free, but no one appreciated the sky that was always blue, and no one congratulated a moon that was always new. Oh, it was planned that they would vanish now and then. And you must pay before you get them back again. That's what storms were made for. And you shouldn't be afraid. For every time it rains, pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains...
Hey, good afternoon. How can I help you? No license plate. For you, no problem.
Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. Raise them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers. For when you hear it thunder, don't run under. There'll be pennies from heaven.
There you go. Give her a couple of tweaks.
And
bring it by anytime.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Brewski. He'll probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
Guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters.
Don't...
Next, you should introduce yourself to Mike Brewski. They probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants. Here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You beat the door and I'll slam you.
Oh, that was bad.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift? Okay, now make a right here. All right, almost there. Make a right up here. That's Mike's junkyard, there. Just drive through the gate.
Hey, look who's here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you can wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know. Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Brewski. But don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your, supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike! You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune.